trip across the plug, we do not play fair, yeah. God. Got them tennis chains on, and they real blingy bling. Draco make it do the chicken head like chingy ching.
Yo, what is good? It's that boy Gibbs back with another one, and today we are talking Marching Type Bird versus Tai Tuivasa. And yeah, man, this could be a good card, man. We got some nice prospects. We got young guys, we got old heads, and we got just a mix of contenders. So with no further ado, we're gonna get into it. But first, like the video and please leave a sub. Like you guys see in the heading, I appreciate all the support. You know, 3 months ago, I would have said, man, this channel ain't growing, man. I'm just gonna quit and stop doing this. But man, the support has been endless, and I will keep it coming because, man, the support's real. And guess what? The picks have been hot, man. We've been on fire. If we had the Michael Venom Page call, we had the Joanne Wood call, you know, the Curtis Blaze, we had that call. We just had a lot of calls. So we're going to go ahead and take a look at the card from last week. So let me go ahead and share my screen with you guys real quick. Boom. All right, there it is. Just share my screen with you guys. Sugar Sean O'Malley versus Chito Vera. So if we can go ahead and go through the card, Joanne Wood versus Marina Moroz had that. Asuk Amabaya versus Cija Vergara had that. Robles de Spain, he looked real good. He dispatched of Josh Parisian in 18 seconds. Michelle Pajeda, nice little choke. Philippe Lenz had that. Underdog call. Carla Phillips had that. Mateus Gamrat called that. Macy Barber called that. Curtis Blades called that. Piotr Jan versus Song Yadong. I did not call that. That was my first loss. Then I went back-to-back losses with Gilbert Burns' loss. Then Michael Venom Page bounced back. I called that, guys. You know I called it. You know I called it. Come on now. I knew he was the better striker in that fight. Dustin Poirier, he did look good. I did not see that happening. I knew he had grit, but I didn't know it was like that. Sugar Sean O'Malley versus Chito Vera. I didn't call that as well, so I was wrong in the main event. But other than that, it was a 10-14 day. It was looking pretty good. I started out 9-0 and then kind of ended off pretty bad. So, you know, if we're talking like an NFL season, you know, you started out good. So we're going to go ahead and keep that going. And we're going to go ahead and slide to this week's card real quick. Tibera. Let's go. Boom. Marching Tibera. For the main event, and then slide over right here. So, dang it, come on. All right, so we're going to go ahead and start with the first fight of the night, and that is Chad Angelica versus Pampos Gregorio. And this is actually going to be a pretty good fight, I must admit. So it's going to be 12-7 for Chad Angelica, 8-3 for Gregorio. Gregorio's coming in as a minus 205 favorite. He's 31 years old, coming in and making his UFC debut. Chad Angelica, he's coming in. He's a plus 170 dog. And if we're going to look at it, Chad Angelica is 0-3 as a UFC dog. So that's something that, you know, you want to definitely note. Chad Angelica, he's a guy who looks good until he's not looking good, because one could say is he doesn't know how to manage his cardio. I could see him coming out looking real composed this time, though, because, you know, he knows that he can't just be coming out like that every time. Gregorio, ferocious. This guy, he had a nice little knockout in Dana White's Contender Series versus Cameron Smotherman. And then he had knocked out Chris Desnell. So I thought that was pretty good in Combat FC. I got to go Pampos Gregorio to win this fight, and I think he's going to win it pretty decisively. And Chad Angelica will be back on the regional scenes after this fight, and his record will be 12-8. Next up, we got Corey McKenna versus Jacqueline Amarine. And this is actually going to be a pretty good fight, I must admit. So if we're going to go ahead and look at the tell of the tape, we got Corey McKenna. She's 8-2. Jacqueline, she's 7-1. Corey McKenna, she's 24 years old. She's really young. Jacqueline Amarine, 28 years old. 5-3 for both of them. But Jacqueline Amarine has almost a 10-inch reach advantage. You have two nice dominant gyms that these gals are in. Team Alpha Male for Poppins McKenna. And then American Top Team for Jacqueline Amarine. I feel like Corey McKenna will probably be losing the first round, and then eventually Corey McKenna will impose her will on Jacqueline Almarine, and I feel like she will just take over from then. So go ahead and give me Corey McKenna by decision. Next up, we got Josh Coulibal versus Danny Silva. And if I can get a look at the line real quick, Josh Coulibal is coming in as a minus 198 favorite. He's 2-0 as a favorite. Danny Silva, he's plus 164 dog, and he's making his UFC debut. this is a featherweight fight. 5'11 for Danny Silva, 5'10 for Josh Coulibal, 73-inch reach advantage for 73 reach for Coulibal, and it's going to be 70-inch reach for Silva. 3-inch reach advantage for Coulibal. So I feel like in this fight, Josh Coulibal would be winning minutes because that's what Josh Coulibal does. Josh Coulibal does have to watch out for the big bombs from Danny Silva because Danny Silva has big bombs in his hands, and this kid's no freaking joke. He knocks people out, and honestly, in my mind, if Angel Pacheco wasn't so tough, he would have knocked Angel Pacheco out in the first round. Let me go ahead and get Josh Coulibal in a decision. I don't see Danny Silva losing by knockout or anything, because you know one could say that he's a undefeated fighter because his one loss came in a split decision. You know, I'm kind of close to leaning towards Danny Silva, but yet I'm still gonna go Josh Coulibal by decision. Next up, we got Thiago Moises versus Mitch Ramirez, and that's gonna be a good fight, I must admit. Thiago Moises, he's coming in. He had a loss to Benoit Saint-Denis. We just seen him lose yesterday or last week, depending on when you're watching this. Mitch Ramirez, a guy who just got a nice little knockout win 2 months ago on the LFA versus Arian Tavares. And that was pretty good. He did get knocked out by Carlos Prats. It was Carlos Prats was definitely doing what he had to do. But it was just like, dang, he did that. I can absolutely see Mitch Ramirez keeping fighting on the feet, and I could see him just imposing his will on Thiago Moises, because what would happen if Thiago Moises was matched up versus this guy? Yeah, that's what I thought. He would knock Thiago Moises the fuck out. So I'm going to go ahead and go Mitch Ramirez because, you know, he's never lost other than that, and, you know, when he's winning, he's looking really good. And we've seen Thiago Moises get knocked out. I got to go Mitch Ramirez. I know that there'd be a discrepancy on the ground. I get that. But, you know, Thiago Moises just hasn't been having confidence as of recent. You know, yeah, he beat Milt Costa. Yeah, he beat Christos Siagos. But, like, bro, those wins aren't that good, though, to be honest with you. He lost to Alvarez and then Islam Makhachev. We can excuse those losses. I have to give him that. But he didn't look good versus Benoit Saint-Denis at all. So we'll just go ahead and get off that fight. I got Mitch Ramirez by TKO. Next up, we got Ode Osborne versus Jafiel Fiallo. And this actually be a pretty good fight, I must admit, because we got Jafiel Fiallo, a guy who's been looking real good, man. He had got that nice little triangle versus Daniel Barres. That fight was a pick'em. You know, I got plus 1,000 on that for a first round submission. That was sweet. Mahmoud Makhachev, you know, I actually had a ticket for him to lose. You know, so I was like, yeah, I wanted to do that. So, yeah, man, I definitely was like, wow, okay. But, you know, I feel like Jafiel Fiallo, a guy who's just, man, the pastor, he's good at winning minutes. And I feel like Ode Osborne, he's not going to be able to do what he wants to do. Jafiel Fiallo, he did get rocked versus Barres in that one fight 7 months ago, but before he turned it around on him. And I have to give him credit for that. Ode Osborne, I definitely feel like Asu Amabayev was able to do what he wanted to do too easy on him, because we just seen a guy that Ode Osborne beat, CJ Vergara, was able to avoid the chokes, unlike Ode Osborne. So if Asu Amabayev, the guy who he's fighting, Fiallo, is a better submission artist than him, you see, you know, he's more potent. He's more potent than Amabayev. Amabayev has a rear naked choke, and that got him out of there. So I just feel like Jafiel Fiallo can actually get this done. Yeah, man, I have to go to Phil Fiajo by submission, and that's actually a pretty confident call, I have to admit. So next up, we got Josie Nunez versus Chelsea Chandler, and this would be a pretty good fight, I must admit, because you got Josie Nunez, a girl who is a girl who's been pretty good, man. She's won her last five fights, and she's been knocking fools out. Not as of recent, but one could say as of recent she hasn't been fighting. One could say the same about Chelsea Chandler. She's only had three fights in 2 years. So Chelsea Chandler, a girl who's finding herself as a dog here. And if you can check the, I haven't checked this in a couple fights. Josie Nunez, she's 2-0. She's 2-0 as a favorite, coming in as a -142 favorite. Chelsea Chandler is a 1-1 underdog. Her dog win came over what was it, Yulia Stolyarenko, and then her dog loss came over Norma Dumont. So Josie Nunez, man, a girl who is 5'2", but yet she has a 67-inch reach. A chick in Chelsea Chandler who's 5'8", but has a 68-inch reach. I thought that's crazy. So I just feel like Chelsea Chandler is just gonna be getting beat up, and she's just gonna be getting out imposed because Josie Nunez, she's gonna be in her face. She ain't gonna be playing around, and we've seen Chelsea Chandler get beat up and start running away from Norma Dumont. So you just never know. I got Josie Nunez to win by TKO, and I feel like this is actually a crazy fight where we're gonna see a women's stoppage. Next up, we got Natan Levy versus Mike Davis, and this is going to be a pretty good fight. Not a damn good fight, but it'd be a pretty good fight. Beast Boy Mike Davis, he's been not the most active guy, but he does have a win over Vyacheslav Borisov. That's Slava Claus, if you're not familiar. Mason Jones took Mason Jones. Oh, but we've seen Mason Jones is kind of a pretender nowadays. Natan Levy coming off a 2-win streak. He beat Mike Breeden, and then he beat Gennaro Valdez. I felt like, yeah, man, Valdez, man, that guy is kind of not that good, so not really a good win. Natan Levy, these odds are actually pretty accurate, so I don't have to go to my odds. While I still show you guys dog favorite, Mike Davis, a 3-0 favorite. Natan Levy is an 0-1 dog. He got his O taken to Rafa Garcia, so basically. The bookies know when Natan Levy's going to win or lose thus far in his career. So, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and go Beast Boy Mike Davis to win by decision. I can't really see Natan Levy getting knocked out in this fight, but you just never know. So, yeah, we're going to go Beast Boy, and yeah, that's that. Gerald Meerschaert versus Brian Barberina. And yeah, man, this is a fight where I seen Gerald Meerschaert quit, man. And I don't like that. He quit in his last fight. And then you got Barberina coming off a 3-fight losing streak. I'll show you guys the tail of the tape. I'm not reading it off. I feel like Brian Barberina, man, dude is kind of old, man. This is a guy, Gerald Meerschaert, a guy who's had 18 fights in the UFC. But yet he's only been a favorite one time. That is terrible. Barbarina's 3-7 as an underdog. That is terrible. So it's just like, come on. But honestly, a guy in Barbarina who has terrible takedown defense, a guy who lost to Jason Witt a couple years back. I have to go Gerald Meerschaert by submission, but this is a fight that everybody should stay away from. But you just never know. Penny Kianzad versus Macy Chazon. And I feel like this is going to be a pretty good fight. Macy Chazon -175 to the +145. I feel like Penny Kianzad, man, she just hasn't been active. She's 0-3 as an underdog. Macy Chazon, she's 1-3-1 as a favorite. So if we're being honest, man, it's kind of easy to call. The bookies know when she's gonna lose. If Penny Kianzad is getting swept, she's gonna get swept in this fight, and she's gonna just be on a 2-fight losing streak. Man, I'm not making this one too hard, man. Y'all seen the stats? I'm going Macy Chazon. Come back and guess what? Macy Chazon win. I bet it too. Isaac Dolgarian versus Christian Rodriguez. And this is actually going to be a pretty damn good fight. You got Christian Rodriguez 10-1, Isaac Dolgarian 6-0, 26 for Rodriguez, 27 for Dolgarian. Both 5'7 and 71 inch reach advantage. So these guys are a mirror of themselves. And this is the weight class that Christian Rodriguez should have been in all along. Yeah, man. I think that C-Rod is going to come in here and he's going to impose his will. Isaac Dolgarian, he's a finisher bust fighter. He's not going to be able to come in here and finish C-Rod like he thinks he's going to be able to. His one loss comes from a decision. And he was never at any point where he was going to get finished. He actually was rocking and Josh Pierce all over the place. I feel like he's going to give Isaac Dolgarian the first loss of his career. And this dude has fought back-to-back undefeated fighters. And he's taking their O's back-to-back. So it's going to be three fights in a row that Isaac Dolgarian has taken undefeated records. I'm taking Christian Rodriguez to beat the Midwest chopper Dolgarian on Saturday. Dog money. Woof, woof. Next up, we got Kenny Najinkoo versus Ovin St. Preux. And honestly, I thought Ovin St. Preux wasn't in the UFC no more. After getting dispatched by Philippe Lenz like that, that was terrible. Exactly 1 year ago, that was terrible. You know, Kenny Najinkoo has only been a favorite seven times. He's a minus 500 favorite here. But he is 4-3 as a favorite. Ovin St. Preux is 5-7 as a dog. And he's a plus 380 dog. Holy smokes. That is crazy. I feel like Kenny Najinkoo is going to knock Ovin St. Preux the fuck out. Because if Philippe Lenz is doing that to you, I know Philippe Lenz is good. I picked Philippe Lenz last week. But Philippe Lenz couldn't finish me. And we're the same size. So that's just my like, nah, bro. It's just not happening. Go ahead and give me Najinkoo the big favorite to win this fight. Next up, we got the co-main event of the evening, Angelusa versus Brian Barberina. And that's going to be a pretty damn good fight. We got 10-2 for Angelusa, 10-3 for Angelusa, 10-2 for Brian Barberina, and for Brian Battle, excuse me, two Brians on the card. It's funny. Minus 150 for Barberina, plus 125 for Lusa. And they're both 29 years old and 6'1 for Brian Battle. And then 5'10 for Angelusa. 3-inch reach advantage for Brian Battle. I feel like this is absolutely a fight where Brian Battle comes in here and he beats Angelusa up. We've seen Angelusa rocked by Reese McKee. We seen him kind of get a little win by AJ Fletcher. But we've seen Brian Battle finish Angelusa. We'll see that on Saturday, but we've seen Brian Battle finish AJ Fletcher. So, you know, give me Brian Battle by TKO. And I feel like, you know, this is actually a pretty good fight. Minus 142 for Angelusa, plus 120 for Angelusa, minus 142 for Pooh Bear. So, yeah, give me Brian Battle. That's going to actually a nice little parlay piece. Next up, we got the main event of the motherfucking evening. It's Tai Tuivasa versus Martin Tybura. Martin Tybura, a guy who is, you know, this guy actually looks good sometimes, man. You got to give him credit. You know, he looked good versus Blagoy Imovov, but, you know, it's Blagoy Imovov. He looked good versus Alexander Romanov. Took Alexander Romanov's O in that fight, actually. And then, you know, he got beat up by Alexander Volkov. So, you know, I just feel like Martin Tybura, this guy is actually better than what people think. If Martin Tybura doesn't get knocked out in this fight, I feel like it's Martin Tybura all day. I absolutely feel like that. Tai Tuivasa, a guy who, you know, one could say is he's knockout or bust. You know, he had that Derek Lewis elbow, and then he had the Augusto Sakai knockout. But one could say he hasn't had a win in 2 years. You know, Martin Tybura. You know, he's had wins. He has had wins in the last year. You know, he did get knocked out by Tom Aspinall. I called that first round knockout. But, you know, I just feel like Bam Bam, Tai Tuivasa, is going to come in here and get back on track, man. I feel like he's going to come in here and just knock. He's just going to knock him out. That's just how I feel, guys. And, you know, we're going to see You know, Ty Burrell, a guy who's 38 years old. We didn't go through the tell of the tape. 38 years old for Ty Burrell. 31 years old for Bam Bam Tuivasa. 6'3 for Ty Burrell. 6'2 for Ty Tuivasa. So a 3-inch reach advantage for Ty Burrell. So, you know, one can say that Bam Bam's going to have to get in there early or he's going to be getting picked apart. This fight's closer than what I actually expected. Give me Bam Bam, but I could absolutely see Ty Burrell winning. And I'm just going to say that I don't like to have that cop out and say both could win, but the odds suggest that. And so does Gibbs. So we're going to go ahead and go over my picks one more time, and then that will be the card. So I got Pompous Grigoroo to win by TKO. I got Corey McKenna to win by decision. I have Josh Koulibaly to win by split decision. I have Mitch Ramirez to win by TKO. I have Jafiel Fiajo to win by decision. I mean, by submission. I have Josie Nunez to win by TKO. I have Mike Davis to win by decision or TKO. I have Gerald Meerschaert to win by decision. Why do I keep saying decision? Submission. I have Penny Kianzad to lose by submission. And then now that one's decision. What the fuck is going on? Christian Rodriguez versus Isaac Dogarian. I have Christian Rodriguez by decision. That's real. I actually have him to win the decision. Christian Rodriguez is just, I feel like he's going to just do that to him, man. So that's the dog of the card for y'all. Kennedy Najitsuku versus Owen St. Preux. I have Kennedy Najitsuku to win by TKO. I have Brian Barberina to knock Anz Luce out for the first time in his career by TKO. And I have Ty Tuivasa to knock out Martin Ty Burrell. That was the picks, guys. That was that boy Gibbs. And, hey, man, we'll be back for Rose Namajunas versus Amanda Ribas. And I think that's actually going to be a pretty good card. You got Simone versus Payne Talbot on that card. So that'd be good, too. So we'll have that broke down. A lot of UFC prospects and UFC debutants on that card. So we're going to have to do some tape on that. But until then, guys, leave some like on the videos and leave a sub. Like I said, man, thank you for the support. I'm going to do a giveaway whenever we get to 180 subs. So we're going to do that, y'all. Get us there. And I'm going to give away some motherfucking money. I'm going to give some units away. So y'all take care, man. Appreciate everybody. And I hope y'all have a good night. And start telling these picks, man. I'm making money, man. I'm making money with these picks, man. Real shit. So until then, I will see you. Peace.